We are day two, the halfway point. When I meet with the artists ahead of time, we meet a couple weeks before, just to give them the lay of the land on Zoom. Hi, Kern, hi, Marty. The lay of the land on Zoom, and I say, make sure that you try to stay present the whole time, because you're going to blink, and the 3 days are going to be gone like that. And so the whole point is to try and just, no matter where you are, just to stay present and kind of soak it up as much as you can, because we're at the halfway point already. And time flies. The hours fly by. But this is the world, and we live in it, and we try, and we try. One of the lovely things this morning, we have private session in the morning where we just sort of decompress a little bit, talk about what we'd like to achieve, talk about what happened, what we'd like to make happen going forward and work a little bit, is they said, you were right, the audience was so nice. I said, yes, they are, super supportive. So just a reminder that this is really, this is all about process. This is all about just how do we go deeper? How do we get more clear? And you'll notice, I mean, certainly from yesterday, but today as well, they're all in a different stage, and they all have different priorities and different things they do well and other things they still are working on. And so the process looks very different for each of the singers, which is why if you're watching at home and you're a young artist, you have your own journey as well. So take notes and see how you can apply it to you, hopefully. We're going to start today. We have a little bit of a Mozart day today, so you know I'm very excited about that. We're going to start with Vitellia. Marissa, welcome. I asked her if she was ready, and she pointed to her shoes, so we're good. Hello, Vitellia. I lied. It's Elettra. But you have to sing Vitellia, too.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Marissa Moultrie, and I will be singing Doreste Daiace from Mozart's Idomeneo.
Thank you.
get into that because I want to set this up. Yep. And then, boom, we fly with Yaria. Yep. Oh, your voice loves this so much. Yeah, we're going to just get right to work, right? We heard them all yesterday, and now we're going to, like, jump in. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready. You're going to, I want you to let me have it.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, you've been singing this aria for
6 months or so.
Do you love it?
Yes.
What do you love about it? Why do you love singing it?
It's intense. Mm. Mm-hmm. But it's still Mozart.
Yeah.
So I love it.
But you love the intensity.
I do love
it.
The intensity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you can lean into it 1,000%
okay.
more.
Yeah.
I think you should let this piece scare you.
Okay.
And I think you're maintaining it just to maintain it. Yeah. And I think you should let it put, it's like the earth is splitting in two out of your rage and fear and intensity, and you can't stop it.
Right.
Okay? Can we start?
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Now, o smania, o furie, o disperate lettera. Why doesn't he say, che smania, la furia, la dis, you know, why does he say, oh, smania, oh, furia, oh, disperata elettra?
Right.
Me.
Yeah.
Why
yeah.
do I have to suffer?
Yeah.
So the O is your key.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
it's, oh, smania, oh, furia, oh, what you really want to say is disperata elettra.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So get us there
okay.
theatrically with your voice.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
What's the first vowel?
Ah.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah?
Yes.
Because it, if you're going to, yeah. this is why I asked, because
yes.
it was sort of this
yes.
and that, right?
Yeah.
Osmania.
Yeah. Yep.
All right? And love that zmania. Osmania.
Mm? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, and you can phonate more on the z.
Yeah.
You're
yeah.
kind of, oh, smania. Oh, smania. Mm. Like it's almost like G N I and z, dup, triple Z, right? Yeah. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Very good. I need you to feel the orchestra more.
Yeah.
I need you to be more connected to the orchestra, right? Oh, smania, oh, furia, oh, disperata elettra. And then he knows right where to put that beat.
Yep, yep.
Okay?
Yep.
But, and each O has to lead up to that top A flat, yeah?
Yeah.
Sing it to me. Ready? And.
Oh, smania.
It's glorious.
Yeah, yeah.
Now I feel like Marissa's arriving.
Okay.
Okay? You see that?
Yep.
It's a bar line. So he gives us mi zera. And if you give us everything on the downbeat, we don't get that mi zera. That's the bar line. I might have just injured something. Don't worry. I'll take it to my teacher later. Just kidding. But that's okay. So we got me da da da. Is that all? It has to open and we have to have the cry. He also gives you another forte piano on the downbeat.
Yeah.
Okay? So give yourself somewhere to go.
Okay.
Now, also, mate, did you feel the progression of Osmania? O Furia?
Yeah.
Oh, these, did you feel that?
Yeah.
Glorious. Addio amor, addio speme, ah, il cor seno, già marno le menide spietate, misera.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay, let it scare you. Can we go from addio amor, the lead into that, please?
Addio amor.
There's something about the way you're releasing these. It's very academic. Okay. You know, it's correct.
Sure.
It's great.
Sure.
But it's not the end of the opera,
Elettra
final thing. Addio amor, addio spene. And each one leads you to the next. And I feel like you're cutting it.
Okay.
Addio amor, addio spene. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So it's addio amor, addio speme, ah, il cuore. Okay?
Yeah.
So, give it to us.
Addio amor, addio speme.
Sfortando
sure.
a little bit. Me. So you got.
Yeah.
Can you try it?
Yeah.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah.
It's glorious that the potency of that note, it's glorious.
Yeah.
But I feel like we don't have anywhere to go with
sure.
it. Me. Pull it back up and then let it crescendo okay. over the bar line.
Yep.
Yeah? One bar before misera. I need to feel the bar line in you. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Try one more time. You're going to get it.
Okay.
Yeah, do it one more time. And you can feel that pulse. One, da, 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 da. Okay? And. Say more this time. Why you don't go either above or below on that with and do an appoggiatura. Che m'arresto, m'arresto, m'arresto.
How can I get,
It doesn't have to be there, but.
Yeah.
Che m'arresto, rampa. If you do it the same, or m'arresto, m'arresto. Either one, but it needs a little something because all of a sudden we're going to go into triplets in the orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And on that, you've got to search.
Mm-hmm.
If you land, okay, okay, what's the right word? How do I feel? What am I resto? You've got it. You don't have it until you sing it.
Okay. Yep.
Search for it.
Okay.
I still feel like you can do more on the bar line.
Sure. Yeah.
I feel, and especially the second one, because the harmony changes. The can you play the harmony at 10, 11, and then keep going?
Oh, I see.
Yeah, just give us the harmony. This weird like major thing which is more painful and it's like that the I am Elettra you know but I'm still miserable you know and so those harmonies are so different you can't sing it the same way I mean you can but you also you could like sang it so feel the harmony in those things. Can we go one before the first misera? Listen to that harmony underneath, how it changes. It if you're really in tune with what's happening, you will sing it differently.
Yeah.
Okay? Listen. Yeah, good. And also how you come off of those each time. Misera, misera, oh, into that, against that amazing harmony in there, okay? All these accompanied recitatives of Mozart are so much about the harmony and singing against it and forcing the orchestra to keep going when you don't have the emotional possibility of going, but it has to because your rage or your sorrow or your pain is so much.
Yeah.
And Elettra is feeling so much that she's making those changes happen underneath her.
Mm-hmm.
It's telling us everything of what's happening here. Mm-hmm. Okay, go forward even more, Marissa.
Okay.
I feel, okay, we're gonna have a moment, right? Okay. Do you mind?
Sure.
I think you don't comprehend how extraordinary you are.
Okay.
I don't think you comprehend, like, how extraordinary your voice is.
Yeah.
Okay? And I think you should be terrified by it. In the best way.
Yeah.
Because once you own it and claim it, you're gonna have to go for it.
Yeah.
Because the world is gonna go, we want that.
Yeah.
Okay? Yeah. And so what you're doing is you're on the safe side back here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is your moment to trust.
Yeah.
This is the moment to trust everything that you are. Yeah?
Yeah.
You want some water?
No, I'm good.
You are good.
I'm good.
You're extraordinary, actually. But you know, I mean, we've been talking a little bit.
Yeah.
And so now is a moment to say, how does it feel if I own it?
Yeah.
Why wait?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, take the power of what you're singing. Let me know if you need a moment. But
I'm good.
I think you are good. But step into it, and you change that harmony.
Yeah.
You be Mozart in this moment, and you change it.
Okay.
Okay? Ken, don't you change unless you believe her. Unless she's making it, okay? Can we start it one more time? Start the whole thing.
Okay.
Yeah? From your breath, and it's in Mozart, and it's in Elettra. This is why it's big stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we have to lean into it at some point.
Yeah.
Catch your breath.
Yeah.
No, wait, just stay with me. Stay with me. I got you. Stay with me. You're good. You're so good. Keep breathing. I mean, okay. Yes. I don't have any. I don't even have my glass. Okay, there we go. So here's the deal. Here's why you guys are so brave. Okay? Here's why you guys are so brave. Because nobody's had to do what you guys have done yet, which is be right on the verge of everything happening, and the world is going, right? It's like literally what's in the music of Elettra. And you guys have been trying to carry on and form this in a box in your room, trying not to sing too loud to disturb your neighbors and to disturb your parents or whatever, right? And now you're so brave to be plunged out into the world, hello, ours again, and in front of people, and you haven't had step by step by step, you know? And there's something in you that is saying, I still have to do it. And I don't know what's going to happen. And I don't know how I'm going to be. And I don't know if it's going to work. But there's something so compelling. So I know, like this. Now you guys are going to see into the world of what we've been doing in our thing. There's something still that you have to put it out into the world.
Yeah.
you know? And here's the really frickin' amazing and frickin' horrifying thing, is you can't do it halfway. This music and life really doesn't work that way. It doesn't, if you only come halfway, it doesn't meet you there. And so you're chasing it, or it's trying to get past the wall, or you're trying to push it away, and it's trying to find, and halfway doesn't work, you know? And at some point, all of us have a moment where we have to let go. And we have to say, I still don't know what's going to happen. And either I'm tired and I'm done and I want to rest and be really good with that, or I don't know what's going to happen and I'm scared to death, but I'm going to go for it. And both of those are great. Both of those are amazing. And I have always said this to singers. It's like, I don't mean to be immodest, but I don't know of any, I mean, there are brave professions and there are people going through a lot. And we've seen that in the last 3 years. But putting your naked self in front of people at this moment in time is an extraordinary thing. I don't know where it's going to bring us. There's no guarantee. I don't know what's going to happen. But I know that it is going to do something to our spirit and our soul that's going to put us in the right place. And if that is on an opera stage or a concert stage or writing grants or teaching or starting an opera company in Kenya, whatever that's going to lead us, we're going to be more in touch with our spirit, our humanity, the reason why it needs to happen, you know? And it just means taking the plunge, like Clarissa in the hours, you know? It's amazing. And it's not the audience's job to feel all that. You know, it's not your job, but it sure helps when you guys understand what it is to put yourself out there. It really helps. It's not your job. It's not your responsibility, but it's awful human and kind. And then when we feel that, the space is open, and then we feel safer, and we feel freer, and you get more. Mm-hmm. And it's this beautiful dance that starts to happen, you know? And, yeah. I'm going to ask you a question, and I really want an honest answer.
Okay.
You don't have to be anything other than to answer it.
Okay.
Like, if you want to keep going, if you want to take a break, we come back to you. If you just want to see what it feels like, if you don't want to do anything until tomorrow, it's all good. But I want you to, like, really feel what you want to do right now.
Mm-hmm.
What feels good to you?
I want to keep going.
I love you for that. And I would have loved you if you said, I want to, I want Anchal to go now, or whoever's next. Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you want some water?
Sure. My water's over there.
And you know what is so cool about this, too? This is another thing. Sorry, I'm talking a lot, and we also want to sing. I know that, too. But especially Elektra and especially Mozart, this aria has reduced singers to tears over the centuries, not because of a pandemic, not because of anything, but just because it's Mozart and it's Elektra, right? And it's just amazing. I like to think, like, Mozart's got our hand, like Mozart's kind of going, I know it's a bitch, like I know. But it's also like so good. And quick story, I was singing Idomeneo in Paris, and my dad died. And I had gone back to the funeral and I had the question, do I want to go on or not? And I totally felt like I could have stayed home. I said, no, I want to go. And there's that Idomeneo aria where he says, I've lost my father. I've lost my father. Il padre ador, my adored father. I lost. And still not quite sure how I did it. But it was like Mozart knew. And without me having to process it, because it was too soon for me to process it, it was moving through me.
Yeah.
It was moving through me. And it's like, not only do I feel like Mozart's got my hand, but all the other singers that have sung this, they've got my hand too. I'm not alone. Frickin' hours everywhere. Or not alone. You may not see that. And certainly we feel alone when it's Mozart and an accompanied recitative and all of that. But you're not alone. And so I want you to feel that support. It's not all on you. You come from a long line of extraordinary experiences with this aria and this character and this composer and opera in general over the centuries. And you align into that energy and feel that and use that.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
You want to go from the start of the recit?
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, smanye. Oh, furie. Oh, disparete, Marissa. You can say that if you want. I love it. We're going to use it.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
But you stack your O's. One, two, three. This is your support. Back here, back here. Go down. Down. Now feel it. The harmony. Down. Beautiful, beautiful. Down. Here. Go deeper. Yeah? Use the words. Down. words.
Ceroste, serpenti.
Right, stay down.
Ceroste, serpenti.
Breath. First of all, that's power, but like, that's sometimes in opera, we have to kind of go to that place. And I've never seen anybody do it in public like that. And I hope you don't feel like you were forced to, but I think you need to feel what your power is. And that's it.
Yeah.
You know, and you can apply that in any direction you want, you know. We would love you to keep singing because your voice is so extraordinary. It's so extraordinary. But you have to feel it and want to share it with us, you know? But it's all there. You have so much inside of you.
Yeah.
So much. Thanks for sharing it with us.
Yeah.
It's so great.
It's so touching.
You got it? Remember yesterday I said, I don't know what's going to happen, but, and it's true, we never know. Hi, Lawrence. Hi, we're happy to see you too. But you know, it's such a tricky thing, a masterclass, because it is literally what I've always said is, it's process. And that huge, everything that we experience in the face of opera is real, and we feel it, and we battle it, and we confront our very humanity with it, you know?
Yeah.
That's why it's the greatest art form in the world, punto, period. Yeah, we're gonna stay with Mozart,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, and we're gonna go to Tito.
Absolutely.
Tell me what you think about Tito.
I think he's a nice guy.
I think so too. I'm really sorry for all the Sestos in the world.
Yeah. a reformed nice guy.
That's important.
Yes.
That's very important, mm-hmm. What you just said.
Yes.
Have you been working on this aria long?
I would say from last year, October.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, and do you love it?
I love it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let us hear the love that you have for it.
Okay.
And let's hear Tito. This is such a good aria for you. It's such a good aria for you, as was Una Furtiva yesterday, which I was still like thinking about last night. It was so lovely. Fantastic.
Thank you.
Now, I'm not sure I believe you.
All right.
We'll That's the only thing. I think it's sung very well.
Okay.
I think technically it's all there. It's kind of ticking all the boxes that it should. But I feel like you're presenting a Mozart aria about an emperor.
Yes, I am.
Mm. And my favorite Titos are the ones who sing it beautifully, but you feel the humanity. Don't be an emperor in this moment, even though you have to be a best friend who's been betrayed.
Okay.
So you're not, this is, you're alone. You're, this isn't for the court. This isn't for anybody. You don't have to be Emperor Tito. But you're working this through, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're working it through because you're smart, because you're fair, because you're just, because you're clement.
Mm-hmm.
But you're also deeply hurt.
Yes.
The one person you could trust. The one person who knows you betrayed you. And that has to be in this as well.
Okay.
Not just proper tenor, Mozart tenor.
Okay.
Don't lose that. Mm-hmm. But it's going to come from the text. Okay?
Yeah.
Se all'impero amici dei. Are you sure that God has your back too?
I'm not sure.
That's a question.
Okay.
You know? How much can you rely on him, or do you feel like you've been abandoned by everybody? When you've been betrayed by the one person that loves you, it calls into question every other person in your life that you thought, including, no offense, but we're human, it happens sometimes, right?
Yeah.
Necessario un cor severo. Do you have a severe heart as Tito? You probably feel it right now.
Mm-hmm.
But do you want to have it?
I don't want to have it.
Huh. But you need it.
Yes.
So there's a lot of conflict happening here. A lot of conflict.
Mm-hmm.
So the way you use the text, the way you sing into the harmonies that are changing underneath you,
mm-hmm.
the way you pull those notes over the bar line, and the way you da ba da ba da ba da ba da Dubba 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 da 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 dee da. Why sesto? Things were going so well.
Okay.
Do you see? So it's how you approach all that. So start playing with the colors.
Okay.
There is the one thing that I will help bring the equanimity into him as well, that sometimes you can exploit and sometimes you can purposefully disbalance. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of skips, vocal skips in this, right?
Yes.
And sometimes, oftentimes, we want it to feel like a horizontal line, not like mm-hmm. Reach, crash, mm-hmm. but yada ba da ba da ba da ba da ba da ba da ba, and it should start to feel a little horizontal. Mm-hmm. The more you do that, the more we understand he's got things under control.
Okay.
And the minute that you also want to play with it a little bit, mm-hmm. we might feel like, oh, he's not sure yet. Mm-hmm. He's saying everything he's supposed to say because it's the right thing, but it's not what you feel in your heart yet. Mm-hmm. Make sense?
Makes sense.
So, just start playing with it.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Just chew on that and let's see what we find. Okay, but actually, can you give us the whole introduction this time? And I need to understand why you have to start this aria.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
They've just carried Sesto away in chains. Just feel it. I could kill him. I'm not ready to kill him. But I could. Thank you, Ken. Thank you. Sorry. Yeah. Oh, that gave me chills. Did you feel the authority that had?
Yes, I did.
And I felt you were a stronger emperor and a more broken man. Sort of oddly at that. You can do a couple things even more, right?
Yes.
I would have a little more, well, pace it. But you could have more disdain for day. I've done everything right for you guys. And this is how you repay me. You know?
Yeah.
Amici dei. You're not my friends. You weren't here when I needed you. But you may want to build to that. But
okay.
That's an option in there.
Yes.
Then when you have this double S, necessario, un cor severo. I love it when you get these sibilants that come together. It's a different color to paint with. Mm-hmm. You know? And
yeah.
You can employ it to different degrees at different times, mm-hmm. while still not disrupting the line, but mm-hmm. you can color those consonants just as much as you're coloring the harmonies in the line.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Can we start it one more time?
Sure.
Try something just as an actor, just for fun. Mm-hmm. Turn, so you've said, get him out of here. I can't even bear to look at him. And you turn around and you're at your desk. And start this into the piano. And don't turn around until you want to open it up with us. Completely alone in the world. Completely alone. And you still have to do the right thing. No. I want you to start that way.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. You gotta love a tenor. I love it. No, but I want you to figure it out on your own first.
Oh, I see. I
got you.
Okay.
Amici,
yes.
And more disdain. The weight of the world is yours to bear alone. You are so alone.
I am so alone.
Feel it.
I
okay?
will feel it.
As Tito, we've
yes.
got your back, Lawrence.
Okay.
As Tito. Heavy. is for me. Take it.
Togliete l'impero, avete un altro cor.
Very good.
Se l'impero, amici dei, necessario un cor severo, o togliete a me l'impero, o a me date un altro cor.
Don't just pump on the brakes. That's extraordinary. It's so beautiful. Don't just go, se-la-da. It goes slower, but the life force. Imagine how fast your heart is beating right now. The butt. Whew. This is part of your talent as an emperor is like, okay, now let me talk this out. But you have to keep the inner life in that. It becomes, don't let it become vertical.
Okay.
Okay, can you give us the three measures play out, Ken? It's gorgeous.
Yeah.
And it starts with this spin. Great, awesome. Now look what he does with that. Se la fede regni
miei.
Yay. Downbeat. End of the phrase. You've got to go to there.
Okay.
The first part. Se la if the, it's not important.
Okay.
If the faithful, whatever it is. So give yourself somewhere to go and give it 50 M's on the miei. Sesto, you did this to me. After all I've done for you, we've got to feel that pain in the miei.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay, and try to feel the subdivision, bom, 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 underneath that eighth note, so it doesn't get stuck. Keep
okay.
it moving. Awesome, beautiful. I love this phrase. When can we go to col amor non assicuro? This is a moment in a Mozart aria, and I'm all about like text and character, but this is a moment I want you to be a clarinet.
Okay.
Okay. Make this as instrumental, because that with Mozart I relate as pure.
Yes.
Pure. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean abandon the text and all of that, but this is sometimes you want to pick up on the instruments from the core. You want to go into that world as well, so it unites what's happening in the orchestra as well. Mm-hmm. You have such a great ooh vowel. So stay with that, and especially on assicuro, col amor non assicuro. And try and make this as instrumental
okay.
as you can.
Yes.
And play also a little bit with the head voice in this. See if you can, I don't know if it will work, but try that color and see how it feels. It gives us a softer side of him.
All right.
We've got the severe side.
Now the okay. soft side.
Yeah, let's see what that feels like.
Okay.
No, legato.
Con amor
Wait.
Non assicuro. Con amor.
No.
Con amor non assicuro.
Yeah, okay, now. that. Do you hear the difference? Mm-hmm. Cola, cola.
Yes.
I mean, first of all, it's just beautiful. It's instrumental, but it keeps your tie to your heartbreak. When you break the sound like that, all the emotion breaks apart too. You don't hold us. We're on a string, and you gotta keep us with you.
Yes.
Now do it the wrong way, con l'amor, and it's the last time you will ever do this in your life. Okay? But get one last shot and do it really not legato at all.
Awesome, I got it. It's gonna be the best.
Just la da da.
Colamo!
Yeah. Beautiful. Now, from now on,
legato.
Give us legato, give us a clarinet.
Okay.
Yeah. Colamo.
Colamor non ha sicuro. Colamor non ha
sicuro. No, that can be more legato.
Sicuro.
Do it again.
Colamor non ha sicuro.
Yeah.
Una fede non mi curo che sia frutto del timor, che sia frutto del timor.
Great, and that's a beautiful moment here also, just musically, you can go, che sia frutto del. Give us the color of that timor, right? Del timor.
Okay.
Okay, paint. Yeah. You're painting with your sorrow there. From the che si frutto. And, sorry. Think instrumental and think heartbreak on any time you get chromatics in Mozart. Okay. Oh, just, Okay?
Yes.
Che si frutto.
Yeah, but if it's more legato, even though there's a double T, che sia frutto, frutto. Find the most painful one of those and make sure you're singing it.
Okay.
Don't take time, but make sure you don't gloss over it, eh?
Yes.
Okay? Che sia frutto. That E natural's just, yeah.
Che sia frutto.
Wait. Duna fede. That's everything to him. That was also magic before. Sorry, I hated to stop you. And what was so beautiful is you found such a gorgeous color on Timor, and you started in that same place for Duna. It was gorgeous. Can we try it one more time from Che sia frutto?
Che sia frutto.
I'm gonna push you. It's your choice.
It's
I'm gonna push you on the beat.
Yes.
Because listen, otherwise it just goes.
Yes.
Yeah, come on the beat.
Okay.
And actually anticipate it a bit.
Okay.
Anticipate it. Da, where it makes us go, oof.
Awesome.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So beautiful. So go from non mi curo. Okay, and do the same thing there with Timor, even though you've done it one time. Choose the word.
Okay.
Timor, that's what I meant. So choose that word in the cadenza.
Okay.
Keep releasing back here.
Yes.
Okay, same thing. Non mi curo.
Non mi curo che sia frutto del
Oh, wait, wait, wait. Sorry. Okay, this is the last thing. It's so good, but it can be magic if you don't automatically know where you're going. Timor. As if you have no choice in the matter.
I see.
I don't have a choice, but I'm going there really consciously. More. That's the way I learned it. You have to find it. Every note.
Yes.
Just the cadenza.
Si.
Okay, but don't give it away too soon.
Okay.
Save the magic for Timor.
Okay.
Don't do too much ahead of time. Then we, you play with us too many times, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. My camera. Just a minute. Just kidding. Singers, I talk about this, and you go, yeah, but you have to find it on your own. You have to be the composer. No offense. I think Kevin Puth was here. Kevin, are you here? He was going to be here. Hi. Never mind. You have to be the composer. You have to be the librettist. You have to be the character, and you have to be inventing it all in the moment. Don't take a single cadence for granted, because you know what? We stop listening. You know what's coming, we know what's coming. And even something that turns out is da ba da da timor, when you do what you just did, we go, oh, it's like the first time we've ever heard it, right? And it doesn't mean become indulgent and start rewriting everything, but it means be in the moment and choose that color and do it with discretion and refinement and grace, as you just did in spades, but don't just land on it. If I swear when conductors go, blomp, blomp, I'm like, no, blomp, blomp. Like, it's like everything has meaning. Everything has to carry, otherwise, we don't listen and we don't care. Yeah? We're leaving the world of Mozart and we're going to Faust, Valentin. Hi, Łukasz. Poland. I love you guys so much. Do you want to let us know what you're singing?
Of course. Hello, everyone. My name is Łukasz Zientarski, and today I would like to present Avant de Quitte from Faust. Soit
This aria in a long time. I forgot how beautiful, because when I was in the college days, this was in every baritone auditions with this, right? And they usually win, because it's like a competition aria. But it's so nice to hear it. Do you do anything that's lighter?
Actually, no.
No, I do, I know, it's not in you, and you love this, and it's so great. But there's so many good things about it. We are going to talk a little bit about the French.
Sure.
It's not as far off as you think it is. Mm-hmm. But what's off is really off. But it's a quick fix, I mean, if we really pay attention to it. And it will change the way you sing it in a good way, I think. But the other thing is, I think, I'm going to tell a quick story.
Yes.
Courtesy of Leonard Folia, who is a fantastic director, and he was a director on Dead Man Walking. I did his production at City Opera literally about 100 years ago and worked with him a few times. We did it in Houston, and we did it most recently in Madrid. And we were revisiting it in Houston, and we had this astonishing experience in rehearsal, in the room. He didn't let anybody from the administration in. It was just the cast and him. We felt so safe. We were really intimate and open and vulnerable in that space. And we were finding something really special. And we went down to stage and I said, Lenny, I said, don't let me start getting all operatic and whatever. And he goes, no, I'll keep an eye on you. And then we were doing this big scene where the mother, who happened to be Frederica von Stade, in her retirement, which was so not a retirement because she's still singing like a goddess now. She's amazing, I miss her, I love her. She was the mother, and we had this scene where she had to say goodbye to her son who was gonna be put to death in an hour. And she was leaving, she got pulled out of the room, and I follow her out, and she realizes she forgot to say goodbye. And there's this extraordinary, very short duet where she's saying, I forgot to say goodbye to my son. And I'm sitting there. I have to go back in as Sister Helen Prejean to be with Joseph as he's put mm-hmm. to death. And I'm trying to hold her up while also facing my own terror and fear. And I was really feeling it. I was really feeling it. And I was acting it. And I was singing it. And I was emoting it. And he came up to me after. He's such a good director because he pulled me away from everybody. He didn't give the note in front of everybody. And he said, you know, Joyce, I feel everything you're doing. And I see it. And I know it's real. But as an audience member, I like to be left a little bit of space to decide what I think you're feeling. And he said, if you give me everything, there's no space for me to enter into your world. You're just telling me, mm-hmm. you're showing me, not shoving it in my face, but it's like, bam, and there's no space. We just go, oh, it sounds good, you know? Now, at the same time, I will also say you have to be 100% committed, and you have to be in every word, and you have to be there, but there's going to be some moment where you can take the foot off the gas mm-hmm. a little bit. All of this is in you. Same as Michele yesterday, right? You feel it. You're living it. It's a source of release for you yes. in your life, and this means so much to you. And I'm glad you have it.
Thank you.
But this isn't the place to work it out now. So your place now is to be Valentin with all of that that you bring to it and to present it and allow us to join in your journey as well as a character.
I will try.
And as a performer. So basically, what it means is you have to trust the music. Mm-hmm. You have to trust that all that emotion is there, and you have to let it flow through you. You drive?
Yes.
Take the foot off the gas about 7%, maybe 12%. Of course it's possible. You showed us yesterday, too. You know, and so all the sorrow, all the suffering, all the pain will be there, but you're not going to be mm-hmm. against it the whole time. It's not written that way also.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
So, can we talk
from
just...
the beginning?
Yeah, but we're going to talk a little bit about the French. Mm-hmm. And basically, there's a couple things. When you have your score, go back and black out every N, mm-hmm. like Vienne, Santa Claus is coming to town, Mon... You're not saying them a lot, but they're mm-hmm. present. And all that can be is viens, mon. It just nasalizes it. Okay. We can't say the end. And then when you have a closed E, écarté, mm-hmm. let it be really closed, écarté. When you have a schwa at the end, au sainte médaille, mm-hmm. those are a bit more They're a bit more open, and we're getting mm-hmm. from you, like E-H, and it needs to really be more schwa. So I, on my French scores, I choose a color for the entire score, and I highlight the schwa at the end, and I want to make sure that all, usually it's green, all the green is always the same vowel. Me, je, veux, que, te, peux, it's super pedantic, but it's important. Avant de quitter ces lieux, that one's a little more closed, and you're opening it. So some of your closed mm-hmm. need to be more open, and some of your opens need to be more closed. That you can work on later. I'm not. Mm-hmm. Don't pay too much attention
sure.
to it today.
But
again, work in progress.
Try, I would like to try.
But what I want to get is the feeling of it. Mm-hmm. Also, expressing in French, as I understand it, comme je comprends, is not expressing the same way as we express in Italian, which is doubling all the consonants. Yeah. De la bataille, de la bataille, mm-hmm. de la bataille. So we want to express by like doubling the B or accenting, and the French language needs more sweep. So it's more about the color, mm-hmm. the legato, the phrasing, where you're going.
Sainte médaille qui me vient de ma sœur.
Another way to think about it is the long notes are faster or shorter, and the short notes are longer.
Sainte médaille qui me vient de ma sœur.
Makes it a little bit more elongated. Hervé, is that correct? C'est juste? Yes. Oui? Hello, I forgot it was a French man in the audience. I make very nervous now.
I'm sorry.
This is the other thing. You know I love the French, but congratulations and good luck in the semifinals, by the way. But it can be totally correct. Like, you can study and study and study, and it will be totally correct. And they go, oui, c'est juste, mais c'est pas français. Oui, c'est juste, mais c'est pas français. Which is why I love that challenge, because if you do get it right, it's magic. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, Valentin, soldier, brother, protective brother.
Of the squad.
The what?
The bravest of the squad.
Yeah.
Always.
Does he know that? Does he know that?
Probably yes. I think he knows.
Well, you're singing him.
Yes.
Does he know that? He knows that. So he doesn't have to show it. Mm-hmm. He is that. You're showing us. With your, okay? Yes. Just be it. Okay? Now, I want you to be over your sister's body. Okay? You've seen her and she's here. Okay? So. Yeah. Voilà. Okay?
Au sainte médaille.
Au
sainte.
Au sein.
Au sein.
Sainte.
That was what I afraid.
No.
Choosing this art.
But don't worry about the French right now. Okay? Don't worry about the French. Mm-hmm. No, it's good because you have to learn it. You should sing this. That's a different kind of work than we're going to do right now.
Yeah.
I just point it out and you can think mm-hmm. about it. But now don't worry about the French, because sometimes you have to prioritize. There's so much to get right, and sometimes you just have to prioritize. Now we're going to go for the style, the ease of it, the expression of it. Put the French in as best you can, okay? But that is also in there, but put it out of your brain right now, okay? So. Listen to this legato at the beginning. It's like a prayer, but it's alive. It's pure. It's beautiful. Enter that world in that same color. Here we go.
Sainte médaille.
Good. Now, take the gas off 7%, okay? More really, really pure, the most beautiful sound you can make. Right on it. One measure, Ken. And here we go.
Mm.
You start so beautifully, mm-hmm. and then you gas it. You know what I mean? Stay there, pure. Listen to this. Mm-hmm. Do exactly what the piano does. Stay there. Did you hear what you did? Wait, you guys got that. I know you did. But you didn't trust it.
Mm-hmm.
And you went, oh, Sainte Médaille. No. No. She's dead. She's here. You're just singing to her. She's just here. She's not there.
No,
No. See, you're worried about how you sound.
Yes, because I'm thinking that it will be too soft.
Can you guys hear him?
Yes.
The opposite happens. Mm-hmm. We don't care when you're trying to make sound.
Mm-hmm.
We don't care. We've heard it before. What we've not heard is Łukasz making a beautiful sound as Valentin in this moment. We've not heard that, but we've heard sound before. It's really important. Okay?
Yes.
The whole introduction, please, Ken. Now, she's here. Okay? And your sound has to be as beautiful as she was. As pure. No gas. And... hear him? Which do you think she would prefer?
I think the second.
Okay. Now, I want to do it again, and I want you to believe it, and mm-hmm. I want you to trust it, and I want you to go further. Not in piano, but in the color and the purity of that line. So go back into the text. Go back into that, this moment that you're living with her, mm-hmm. and I want it to be the most beautiful sound you've ever made. Okay?
Yes.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Just one measure. She's here. Don't forget your breath. Trust it. Mm-hmm. Trust it. Join that. That's the tear, that's the... I know I have to say goodbye. I know I have to say goodbye. Now, here we're going to stand up. Because do you hear how you've given that? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Do you feel how it's so beautiful? It's tender. It's, dare I say, like a real man who can be that way. It's not a, whoa, 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 whoa. I went to war and I'm a da, da, da. No. It's like he's, I don't know what that was. Well, now you know who I really am. It's tenderness, and it's beauty of voice. That is a moment. All we want is beauty of sound for the sake mm-hmm. of saying goodbye. And now you can go into Valentin world. Make sense?
For the bottle, yes.
But only because you've earned it from showing us that side of him. And you feel what that sound does to them, yeah? Do you trust it?
Yes.
It's beautiful.
That's changed everything.
Well, you don't have to. You don't have to change it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be one-dimensional.
Yeah.
And I don't think that's what you want. Right?
Yes.
And I think sometimes we think that it needs to be this when we don't actually examine it. You look at how the orchestra is written, how it's sustained, the actual dramatic moment. It needs tenderness. And for me, the moments of tenderness and beauty in the opera are the ones that I remember. And then it's exciting, mm-hmm. you know, then when you add the virility and the rhythm and the power to it, you put the gas back onto it, but it's not the whole time. And you're letting us feel, do you feel how they were leaning in?
Yes.
It's not because you were on the floor, it's because the quality of your sound. You left space for them to come into that. Yeah? We have to stop there.
Sure.
It's fantastic.
Thank you very much.
So good. Thank you. Thank you. The time. I have my glasses, but I forgot my 5:22. Oh, we're good. I've sort of instinctually been okay. Hello. What are we doing today?
Caro nome. Yep.
Yep. You want to? Yeah, we start with the rest of it and we go. We're definitely not going to do the whole aria. I know we're going to jump right in and work.
Yeah,
I'm so excited. Okay.
Would you like me to start with the recit, though?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Hi, everyone. This is Caro Nome from Rigoletto by Verdi.
And I would just like to make a preference here. Anchal is our youngest. Can we say your age?
Yeah,
I think it's written. You're 21.
Yeah.
Right. So it's not always intended this way, but often it works out that we take quite a young singer. Kaylee Decker, I think, was our first one. I want to say she was 20 when she was 19. And she just sang Isolier for the Chicago Lyric Opera. I'm so, yay, Kaylee, woo! She's doing really well there. She's doing great. But this is, it's a different level of things that we're working on. And what we talked a little bit about yesterday, but certainly this morning, is one thing she doesn't have to worry about is performing and expression and character. That you have in spades. You will refine it, you'll get better at it, you'll get more sophisticated, mm-hmm. you'll be able to find different colors, but that comes naturally to you. And what you've been asking your voice to do is fast forward to all that expression and all that characterization without going, hold on a second, I haven't, like, can I do like ABC first, right? And it's really hard when you know what you want to do. But we were also talking, Alexis, we were talking about this today as well with you, that the demands of operatic singing are so big that your technique has to be so disciplined mm-hmm. and so like a pianist, like a violinist, like a cellist, and you have to work at it much longer than you want to because you want to get on stage, you want to be the character, you got to back up, go into slow motion, do the vocalizing, work on the, do all of that really pedantic discipline training so that when you're having your long career, your voice is still serving your expressive desire. And you are not at the mercy of a voice that can only do certain things a certain way. And that takes time and discipline. Okay? So, we are going to do Caro Nome today, mm-hmm. but we are not going to see Gilda just yet.
Okay.
We are going to see 21-year-old Anchal working on the vocal aspect. This is what I call cold tap and hot tap.
Mm-hmm.
Cold tap is just the technique. Hot tap is the fire, right? Marissa, we were all hot tap earlier, right? Yeah, I love that. But you're in a different place, technically. So this is all cold tap. It's going to feel terrible to you, but you can learn to enjoy this part of it as well. This is the vocal mastery, okay? So don't worry about your posture. Take your shoes off. Do you mind? You look great. Take your shoes off.
This is my dream come true.
Girl. Right? And this is just vocalizing 101.
Okay.
Okay? So text, legato, tone. There's no Gilda here yet.
Okay.
Okay.
I can just stand here and...
What do you think? But see, I doubt you've ever stood in front of an audience and not been a character before.
Yeah.
It's not in you. So this is hard for you. This is hard for you.
Yeah.
So turn all of that off. There's no expression here. This is vocal work.
Okay.
Okay?
Let's do it.
Yeah. No. Yeah, cool. So what are you thinking right now?
Exhale.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Okay. And you know what your first note is and where it's going?
I'm going to inhale for the entire measure and then release this and gua.
Okay. You also don't have to breathe in the whole measure.
Yeah.
That's a lot of pressure.
Okay.
You could also just be like, okay, my first vowel is gua.
Okay.
Drop, open, go.
Okay.
Okay. Actually, just don't even give us the intro, okay. Justina. Yeah. So give us just a chord. Okay, what dynamic is that?
I would like it to be piano in my head, but it's, I think what it is right now is just a mezzo forte, what's coming out.
Ah, I would say it's like a perched piano, attempt at piano. That's what it sounds like.
Okay.
Because you're still trying to be Gilda. Give me a good mezzo forte, ah, connected, breath spinning for that whole time.
Okay.
Through the 16th note and through the whole note.
Okay.
Okay? I was not lying, we're not going to get through the aria. I didn't know. Just the chord. Yeah. Just drop and sing, phone it. Don't think so much about it. Okay? Okay, can you do nome di lui just on vowels?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You can use this if you want. When you go to vowels, it's tricky. So, I wanted to try it, and then I was like, I'm not sure it's going to be good, so I won't. Literally, I was like, the C sharp sounds pretty good. Maybe I could sing it. No. But so just phonate, just on the vowels.
Okay.
Ready? And. Now imagine that it's coming from here. So your breath is doing that, nothing else. Yeah. And nom, oh, oh, eh. Just sing it, just phonate it. Oh, say oh.
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 Oh. Oh. And as you say oh, it goes longer.
Oh.
Okay, oh, me. Length. But don't close it too much. So, mm-hmm. Innamorato.
Innamorato.
Ecco. There we go. Innamorato.
Innamorato.
No,
yeah,
no,
I did all these things.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't help it.
Vowel,
oh my goodness.
Right?
Yeah.
Do you see? You're already asking this to express, and we just want it cold. Am I on a pure vowel? Is it steady? Is it breathing? Am I releasing? Am I lengthening? Am I lengthening? Am I getting to the end of a phrase?
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
It's that kind of evaluation.
Yeah.
Iaorato. Feel the pitch and the harmony and all that, but this is about equalized sound, okay?
So on vowels?
Yeah.
My
here.
Tough them.
There's nothing happening here, right? Boom. But legato through every vowel onto each note, okay? You're being super musical. Okay, through and no break in sound, legato, 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 one tied to the next, and breathe. Keep going, keep going. Something like that, you know, first of all, you're going to start every audition for the next 5 years with this, probably. This will be a competition aria for you, and that is always going to be a place you want to run out of breath.
Yes.
Or you will run out of breath because you're nervous. So start training it now to sing it 2 measures long. So that you're in command of how that phrase goes, no matter how nervous you are.
Yes.
Train it differently.
Okay.
Every time you sing it, extend it 2 bars. And then when you only have to do it a quarter note, you're like, pfft. Then you can diminuendo on it and release in this glorious, fantastic, expressive way.
Mm-hmm.
But not at this point.
Okay.
Okay, same thing. Nome di lui, vowels. The most legato, most beautiful, tall sound based on your breath. Just, it's just going you for days.
Okay.
Just on vowels, okay? Mezzo forte.
Okay.
Okay, just sing it. The tongue is just changing.
So I don't need to ease into everything? I just kind of let go into each vowel?
What do you mean ease into it?
The way I'm thinking of legato is...
That's not what you did.
Oh, that wasn't what... Yeah. Okay.
I'm a fan of that.
Okay, I can... I'm gonna try that again.
Yeah. Well, don't think about it too much. Just don't let anything shift. Legato.
Okay.
And where is it happening? What else is happening?
Tongue is changing positions.
That's it.
Yeah.
But the air is constant, so you can go from oh. It's just this, but the breath is constant.
Okay.
Legato. Okay? So go ease into it, go in slow motion. It doesn't have to be in rhythm. Justina will follow you. But keep, feel what that legato is on a tall column of breath, okay? It's such a good, I mean, also just warm up on this.
Yeah.
It's a vocalise, okay?
And.
Yeah. But, sing it.
Okay.
You're perching on it. You're kind of perching. Okay, there, do you feel the bump?
I felt a
little bump. Yep. Yeah.
So go slower through that and figure that out. Oh, very good. Very good. Very good. Now do that with authority and breath and not careful. But that's it.
Yeah.
You guys hear that? I know you do. Yeah? It's on your breath. It's not in your hands. Long, right? Long. Okay. Do you feel how you have to move through it to keep that breath going? You're kind of
perching.
Yeah. What helps me on something like that is to think that I'm lengthening. The sternum's getting longer, and I'm going to trust that it's going to keep phonating, because the minute we think it might not, we grab something and we make it happen with our jaw. So, I'm going longer, and I'm making sure the breath is there, and so that whatever the tongue is doing, nothing shifts gears.
Okay.
Try and get longer.
Okay.
Okay. E. Yeah. E. Okay.
E.
Yeah. There you go. You're an aria, you keep rehearsing it that way. And you determine when to come off of it. Your body doesn't go, I'm done.
Yep.
And you panic.
Yep.
Make sense?
Yes.
I want to stay on the vowel going forward. Yep.
Okay. Right on it.
And legato. I don't want staccato. For mezzo forte sung.
Okay.
Right through the middle of every note. It's like the most intense connection is in the middle of the two quarter notes, where the eighth rest is. I'm not crescendoing, but I'm not letting it go.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And whoa. Oh, you're perching. No, sing it. This is like, imagine this is Nessun Dorma or Mira Unorma or something like that. Okay. Sing it. Caro nome. Connected. Do you feel that? Do you feel that?
Yes.
Yeah. And this can be how you warm up. This can be your vocalize. This can be like, I'm just going to see what that feels like. And then when it comes time to caron, you're not going to go caron. You know, you're going to sing it. It's going to be there. Because your body has figured it out. Your brain knows where it's going. It has a reference point. It's got a pillar upon which to plant itself.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. This is really good work. It's really good work. And the more you embrace it, is like, I love this part of it because I know it's going to make my expression, my character so much better. Mm. And just say, get off the stage, Anchal. Like, there's time for that. You don't have to worry about it. That's going to be there. But this, you want this totally at your service because you have so much imagination, so many ideas, so many things you want to show the world. Let your desire run the show and not be inhibited by not having your total voice and body at your command.
Yes.
For the, especially the kind of repertoire you're gonna do.
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yes.
It's beautiful.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Do we know what time it is? 20 to 6. We're good, and we will have time for question and answer afterwards. Fantastic, but we get Handel now. Yay, Rael! Welcome, you look gorgeous. You look gorgeous. Go for it.
Hello, good evening. My name is Rael Rent, and this is Pena Tiranna from Amadigi di Gaula. My character, Dardano, is the Prince of Thrace, and in the second act of the opera, sings of incredible heartache and how he just cannot find solace anymore anywhere.
Non sventurato amante, provo tutte le pene in questo petto. Amoriana madigi e me disprezza, mi promette Melissa conforto al mio tormento, ma tardi veggio, Dio, che vano ogni potere al duolo mio.
It feels like you identify so much with it. You really feel this musically.
I do. It's very easy to feel very intense emotions for me. But it's also very difficult because I do get the shaky.
So what do you do if you get that?
I do fists.
Well, that's good. That's a good strategy.
But that also means I get lines in my palms from my nails.
Wait,
it goes away really quickly. That's fine.
Visi darte. Well, I want to find something else for that.
Oh, no, no.
That's intense. Mm.
C'est la vie.
C'est la vie. Visi darte. Okay. But I just wonder, actually, but I mean, that's a very interesting thing. It means that you're having to release energy in some other way rather than just pwa. Mm-hmm. So ultimately, we want you in a place that all your energy is going with the breath. Yeah. Chances are, and it happens to, I mean, I sometimes we'll see like, whoa, what is that? Okay. Then you can find other places to put it, or, you know, eyebrows shake or different things happen. There's a lot of adrenaline going through the body of a singer at any given time. It would be great, though, also if you try some different things so you don't have in the privacy of your own whatever, so that you have other options and you're training your body to release it in a different way. Yep. Maybe you want to move around, maybe you want to walk in a circle, but otherwise you're neurologically putting that in one way in your body.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's just an interesting thing. It's good that you observe it, but I would pay attention to that a little bit. Talk to me about where you are at the beginning of this versus the end after you've gone through your gorgeous B section. What's the change that you've made?
Dramatically?
Yeah.
In my mind, it's, especially going back to the gorgeous introduction for the aria, the second time around is much more dramatic, but it's also, in Dardano's mind, at least in my mind, it's sort of having to make peace with the fact that, yeah, I will not find peace. Mm-hmm. That is my life. I'll probably die for love, but... Again, c'est la vie.
Yeah. And the first time through, you're feeling it a little bit more?
I suppose, yes. And then the second time is the release. Mm. At least that's what I'm trying to get out.
Well, but I think the most important thing is that it's organized in your head.
Yeah.
So that, and not that that doesn't mean you're locked in. You could still handle arias have a way of of taking you where they want you to, yeah. where they want to take you. And sometimes you have to be open to that inspiration mm-hmm. as well. But I think it's good to have an architecture. They're long, they're repetitive. And if the necessity to repeat a line mm-hmm. isn't really clear in your brain, mm-hmm. you're gonna lose your audience a little bit, yeah. you know? So it's, you know, it's very interesting. Sometimes Handel arias, when they're very sad and painful, they're much more beautiful. And this one is quite aggressive. It's quite vertical. Mm-hmm. It's a bam, bam, da-da, da-da. Mm-hmm. And I think that informs a lot. And then you get this beautiful line over it. Mm-hmm. But I would pay close attention to where he has rests. Mm-hmm. And only go over them in the da capo as a kind of ornament. Right. But I think they're there to give a kind of aggressivity mm-hmm. to it, okay? And so that can happen in a lot of different ways. Can we start with the B section, actually? Amor m'affanna e il mio dolore, in tanti guai pace non ha. Pace Nona is not here. Can we go just from the, mm-hmm. maybe the play, a little bit of the play out would be great. Okay, so can we go back, if you remember a little bit the work we did this morning, mm-hmm. with the bin bomb, hello. You don't need any sound, you don't need yeah. any opening. It's just bring those chords together and let the vowels do all the work, okay? This, you don't have to create a ton of space for this. This is in a sweet spot for you. Mm-hmm. So just let those chords come together and just phonate the vowel.
Okay.
Really do the eighth note there. Mm-hmm. He's giving you pace. Nona. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Keep going in this direction of just say ah. Ah.
Ah.
Ah.
Ah.
Ah.
Ah.
Ah. Ah. Not
ah. Ah.
I hear UH. I hear
Ah.
And I went ah.
Ah.
Yeah.
AW.
Well, amor.
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 Yeah. Not amor, but really amor. And so it's a very clean start.
Amor.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Okay? Mm. Yeah. I also want to do just vowels with you.
Okay.
Oh, I want the legato more. But just, we're going to keep the consonants and mm-hmm. all, keep the consonants legato and on the breath as well, okay? Mm-hmm. And just write on it, amor. Mm. Ah.
Amor m'affanna e il mio dolore.
Yeah, and that you can find that fantastic harmonic change.
E il mio dolore.
That should take us completely by surprise. Mm-hmm. And you're singing it like we know it's coming. Start with amor one more time. We get major all of a sudden on dolore. Mm-hmm. Enjoy that.
Okay.
Handel. Amor.
Amor m'affanna e il mio dolore in tanti.
Ah, tanti.
So he's given legato.
Yeah.
Legato. Then he goes, in tanti guai. In tanti guai. I have to go on.
Mm-hmm.
So that is really important.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it sounds exactly like the first two phrases. It's a little eighth rest. One more. And so in order to actually highlight that, keep these first two phrases super legato in the middle of the bar. Amor m'affanna, il mio dolore. Mm-hmm. And you make the harmonic change happen.
Okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Because it's bitterly ironic.
Yeah.
Amor m'affanna, il mio dolore. Thanks a lot, life. You know, yeah, I feel my pain. Mm-hmm. It's very ironic that it goes major there, right?
Yeah.
Okay? Then really let us feel those two eighth notes. Okay. Rests. Great. But you've got to get us to affanna. Mm-hmm. I get amor m'affanna.
Amor m'affanna, e il mio dolore, in tanti guai.
Now stop it!
No.
Oh! It's so tiny. It's nothing. And it's so easy to just sing it the way the other two phrases were. And yet when you do it like that, it breaks our heart. It's not rocket science. Singers, it's not rocket science. Listen to Callas, come scritto. Do what's on the page. Because that, I'm not crazy. It makes all the difference. Quite honestly, you know I love Handel, but there is nothing worse than a Handel aria that is sung as if we know how it's gonna go, especially the slow ones. Or, no offense, the bass baritone ones that he had to put into the opera that are just kind of like, okay. Do you know what you did?
Watch it back and then I'll know even more.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot happening up here. Sometimes it takes a minute to process it. It's true. But you simply went in tan, took the eighth rest, but you did it artistically, tan ti guai. And it just tells us so much about your character. Listen to the difference. In tanti guai, in tanti guai. It's not rocket science. I'm saying the word tanti, and I'm doing the eighth rest. But I'm doing it because he's breaking. But what's going to come back is dun, dun. Ba-dun-dun. You're not going to let yourself break, but you're breaking. Okay? So do you know what you did?
Yes. I'll do it again.
Okay? But earn it by the way you sing the first two phrases. Mm-hmm. Don't make it automatic.
Okay.
Wait. Why are you starting the B section? Yeah. That's a legitimate answer. But you know what I already see? I see all the text already there. I don't feel you creating it.
Okay.
And I don't feel you searching for it, mm-hmm. especially on an aria like this.
Okay.
How do I describe it? What's it doing to me? It could be amor, amor. No, it's amor, m'affanna. And then the relief of finding the right word. Amor, m'affanna. Now I have strength to go on. Il mio dolore. Not il mio dolore. It's the most automatic thing in the world.
Yeah.
It's that the pain, the suffering of amor m'affanno. It hurts so bad, I'm going to make it major.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
And then, intan, ti guai. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't be simpler, right? Find it. What is it?
Amor m'affanno.
Okay, but okay, you're do yes. I see you now. Yeah, I hate to stop you, but if you go, we lose the G sharp.
Yeah.
So have the restraint. And make it hurt there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But the amor, did you guys feel the difference?
Yeah.
We didn't know what was coming, even though we've heard it 10 times already. Because you were looking for it.
Yeah.
Trust that. Do that.
Okay.
What is it? So the first time you get in tan ti gua, and the second one he goes you over the bar line in tan ti guai pace non amor. Trust that you have enough breath there to really sing through that. And we have to understand the change of word. Non amo. You don't have to glottal it, but it, you have to mentally go into the new word.
Mm-hmm.
Now, beautiful. Let's go back and do the top again, mm-hmm. the same thing, and sing it. Mm-hmm. So this is balancing expression and singing. That was super expressive. We still need you phonating the mm-hmm. whole time. So feel all of that, but keep it phonating,
mm-hmm.
okay? What is it?
Amor m'affanno.
Ah, here.
E il mio dolore in tanti guai pace non ha.
I think musically and textually you could say la tan
in tanti.
In tanti guai, breathe and interrupt with pace nona. And so I would breathe before pace.
Okay.
See how that feels.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go from in tanti guai and here.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Over the bar line.
In ta-
make the bar line hurt.
Okay.
Now just relax into it. Just relax into it, but feel it, okay?
Yeah.
Here he goes. makes micro tiny adjustments.
Yeah.
And I want you to have a reason for all of that,
mm-hmm.
you know? And how it pulls you to the next and pulls you to the next phrase. That's beautiful. This is expression being sung really well, phonating, not forcing, but it's like, okay, a little less, a little more of that, no, not so much there. That's the fine phase thing. Where this is, exactly. Can we go the same place, over the bar line, in tanti. Okay, this is super subtle. You have to make the bar happen. And right now you're responding to it. It's like you conjure the bar line. You know what I mean? It's a weird thing. But you're sort of like responding to it, and I need you to conjure it from the way you start. Intanti. Okay? How's that feel?
If I talk about it, I'm going to cry.
Your choice.
It feels good.
Good.
In the best way possible.
Yeah.
And it makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful that way. And here's the other thing. Sometimes when you do this kind of work, the voice just starts arriving because you're demanding the emotion of it. Not forcing it, not pushing it on us like Valentin, but you're in it and you're doing the musical phrasing and your voice starts to go, oh, I know where to go.
Mm.
And sometimes we need to start from the voice. Sometimes we need to say, let's not overthink the voice, but let's give it a place to go, and the voice shows up and goes, oh, I've been waiting to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Because now, like, your voice is the column, you'll hear it. The column is coming. It's the color is so beautiful. It's so mellow. And it's comforting. It's comforting, but you've got to give it that direction
mm-hmm.
in where to go.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Welcome. Are we okay on time? We can take some questions. Feel free if you need to dash to dinner or to a show or whatever. No problem. But I do, last night we didn't get to do questions, and I'd be very happy to make that happen today if there are any. Yes.
It's actually a statement. As somebody who used
to do you mind to just take the microphone? Sorry, I should have announced that. Then the folks watching at home.
In listening to you and observing the true art of teaching singers, I wanted to let you know that it's helped me learn to listen to this wonderful opera art form going forward in a different way, because mm-hmm. one of the things that I heard that was consistent with every singer that you were working with is to help the singer lean into the tension between the vocalization, the libretto, and the dance between the music and the orchestra. Because when you lean in to the tension, you take the audience with you on that journey. And that's something that in 30 years of listening to opera, and I used to sing professionally way back in the day, I've never listened to music to listen for the tension before today, and so this has taken me on a different journey, and so as an audience member, I just wanted to say thank you for that.
Oh, that's lovely. Sometimes there's tension up there, but we don't mean it. But that's okay. I mean, I do. And the thing is, this is why, I mean, I just love every single one of you guys and what you bring, because we can say, well, Mozart should be blah, blah, blah. But where are you on your vocal journey, your Mozart journey? You know, there's so many other things to juggle, and sometimes you have to prioritize, okay, the language or the rhythm or the intention. And it's why it's overwhelming when you're starting out, especially when you know where you want to go. But you got to slow down and just start ticking the boxes as best you can. Yes. Hi.
Hello. I think when Marissa was working, you mentioned the Mrs. Dalloway adaptation, The Hours, and I was just curious what the context or what idea you were referencing.
I referenced about 10 things with you, and I'm not sure which one I...
Something about Clarissa choosing, I think.
Yeah, plunging. Mm. Clarissa was plunging, and that's a theme that comes back a couple times with each of the women in The Hours, and we are plunging forward. We're taking, you know, what a lark, what a plunge. Virginia wrote that in Mrs. Dalloway. Mm-hmm. And I love that metaphor, too. It's like sometimes you just got to plunge in. You just got to jump. And, you know, who knows where it's going to lead you. But you're not going to be in the same place you were. And it's easy to stay back and not do anything. But that's not always helpful. I wouldn't plunge all the time. I mean, you want to plunge, you know, like, I mean, the plunge we saw you take today, Marissa, was incredibly brave and beautiful, and I guarantee you, and I haven't even read any comments yet, I guarantee you what you lived here is what many of your colleagues that you don't even know is also living. And by you plunging, you give permission for other people to go forward as well. And that's also part of what I want these classes to be. You know, I have my own difficult stories about getting started. There's not a singer alive that hasn't faced such heartbreak multiple times at every level of career. Even the people who are on top, it's a different kind of heartbreak than not getting the role you really wanted or into the young artist program you wanted. But we all face it, and the singers that we easily judge for, well, the top note or this or that, they're up there fighting for their life many times. Mm-hmm. And they're doing it out of generosity, out of need, out of fear, out of exhilaration. And it's just one of the most brave things I've ever witnessed. So every time you see a singer take the stage, they are plunging, sometimes literally. Oh, let's stay here while the microphone is here, and we'll work our way over.
Hi. So since you're someone who can sing in all varying genres and eras and all of that, what have you found to be most helpful in finding that kind of versatility of era and expression and all of that throughout the history of music?
A really solid, bankable technique that is at my service. So that, I mean, really, the way when I sing Handel, I'll use straight tone, I'll use full on, I mean, Agrippina, Pensieri, you know, I will sing. I need florid notes that are hopefully legato, I need breath. Seemingly for days, or at least make you think that I have it for days. And for example, I'm singing Virginia Woolf now, and I'm like, ooh, if I do this, if I hollow out the sound, I don't want to say make it straight tone, but if I hollow out the sound, we're going to know that something's unstable inside, then she doesn't have anything to hold on to right now. So I like, and I work at my technique so that whatever color I want to play with is at my disposal. And if something tightens or it's not working, I'm like, I'm holding somewhere, something's not working. And either I might abandon and say, okay, that's not going to work on that note or whatever, but I want a treasure chest of colors people haven't even heard before. My best teacher for that, Ella Fitzgerald. She can, you have to rewind on like how high the moon going. Is that a trumpet? That's freaking Ella. No, it's just amazing. Because, again, part of what we're talking about, look at just the extremity of emotion we've just met today. A lettre at the end of, oh, powerful woman at the end of her rope. Tito, betrayed with the weight of the world on him and still finding the way not to go with what the public would demand, but to do the right thing. And fighting against all his betrayal and all his hurt to do the right thing. Valentin weeping, a big, fantastic, bravest soldier of the whole thing, weeping and praying over his sister. You know, I mean, it's, we don't just need a good ah vowel. I mean, that's the fundamental basis. We need that ah vowel, but we need that ah vowel to be the cry of humanity and the cry of a first love and the cry of betrayal. It needs to be many things. And the only way for me to do that, regardless, I don't think, oh, this is Rossini, it has to be this, is to just keep working on my technique. And working, and I have a lesson in there. Hi, oh, do we have one from the internets?
This is actually somebody who I think wrote in the question in two different places, so she really wants to know, and I want to know the answer also. My question for Joyce is, could you please explain how to make quick breaths count? We don't always get moments to completely fill up on air, and I'm struggling with quick breaths.
Okay, hang in there. Hang in there. I would say 7.5 times out of 10, you probably don't need the breath. And you probably don't need to gasp for the breath. The thing is just kind of stop and just open and the breath comes in. Usually when we're getting in my experience, when I'm getting into trouble of not having a breath, it's because I've overbreathed. Who's the tenor who said you only need like a thumb bolt, a thimble full of breath? One of the big tenors, Gedda or somebody, I don't know. But we need much less breath than we actually think about. So the thing is you want to practice it slow. You want to practice it not as a reaction, like, I got to get the breath because this long phrase is coming. You just want to sing the phrase, stop, give yourself a good breath, and carry on, and build it in that way so that your body learns, I don't have to panic at this moment. Most of the thing is just take out the panic of the situation, and your body will be there. Has been my experience. Yeah. Oh, we have a microphone. Perfect.
Hi. I just want to go back a little bit, Marissa, and thank you so much for opening your heart in this moment. It was really, really magical. And I want to see how you handled when there is so much emotion that we're overwhelmed with the character or a situation that's very personal that we're going through that relates to our character, to our singing. How do you handle the technique on that point? Are you... So, because sometimes we're so overwhelmed with the emotion and what's going on that it breaks. We don't have that breath. We don't have that. So how do we handle that emotion and keep it in place to serve the voice?
There's a couple things I would say about that. Is number one, I've spoken about this before, but it's how you rehearse. So for those moments that you know are the trigger moments, let yourself go there in rehearsal. That's why we're there. And you need to know where that limit is. You need to know where the music and the emotion wants to take you and let yourself go there. Then after you've done that, there's a moment, we talked about this among the Miss Kelly and Miss Renee and myself, because it took us a long time to get through the final trio of the hours. And Renee was like, I gotta get this out of my system now because I have to sing. Like your job is to show up. It's not the therapy session, which may be residual for you on the side, but it's not your moment for therapy. Your moment is to sing and let the audience have their catharsis. So you have a job to do, and I'm very black and white about that. But I have accessed that previously so that it will move through me. The other thing, in the heat of the moment, which may happen, do you hear what I was saying to you? I was like, text, text, text. Keep your mind coming back to the job at hand. because you can easily go, oh, but I'm feeling text. Serpente, celeste, serpente. And if your mind is 100% there, it's your emotion is taking a parallel ride, but it's not driving the car. Keep it focused. I mean, my fantastic college opera director, George Gibson at Wichita State, was like, Joyce, darling, 10% always must be just intellect. Like, you've just got to keep 10% on the task at hand. And sometimes you may feel like you're not emoting or fully involved, but it is such a complex thing that's happening up here that if you just give over, you're going to look up and the conductor is going to be like, get back on. You're, oh, right, right. Or a big one of these. I saw that a few times in the air. Wait. No. Yeah. Another question? Yes, hi.
Hello.
Hello.
I grew up in Wichita.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Go Shockers.
Anyways. Yeah, right. I was going to ask, can you speak on your journey with education specifically alongside your performance career and how that has informed your artistry? And, you know, did you come to that consciously, intentionally, or is it something that, you know, swept you away as it does a lot of us? It's, yeah, you know, such a beautiful gift to have.
Thank you. I might finish up with this question then, because there's a few things I could talk about with that. I'm that kid in Kansas City that had the choral experience and the high school musical experience to end all experiences. Even though I wasn't the lead, I lived for it. And I was the one in the final concert my senior year at Bishop Miege High School going, I didn't sing a note on the whole final concert because I was so sad and I thought I'm never gonna have any musical experience ever as good as what we're doing in our senior farewell concert at Bishop Miege High School in 1987. And I knew as I graduated from Bishop Miege High School in 1987 that I was going to be a high school music teacher. I was sure of it and I was gonna be cool. I didn't know how, but I knew I was going to be cool. And I went and I did education. I did music ed at Wichita State. And I went all the way through. I did student teaching. And I was in tough schools. You know, Wichita has some places of real need in it. And I remember mornings were grade school and afternoons were the high school. And I just thought, these kids need so much. And it's all about education, it's not about music. And I'm not sure, I don't know what to do. I was really confused. I went to my dad. I said, Dad, and at that point I was starting to do shows, opera as well, at Wichita State. And I said, that feels really selfish, but I feel like I should be in the classroom because there's so much need. And he said, I'll never forget it, I mention it often, he said there's more than one way to educate and reach people. And it was just the right thing at the right moment that it unlocked something and gave me permission to go forward in what was felt like was really calling me, which was the stage. And, but stardom never, that was never my goal. And as I started to do more and more, I was kind of like, oh, this is not so comfortable with all that, and there's still a lot of need, and there's still a lot of people that want to connect through music. And it's been really such a gift for me, and I think it's kept me super passionate about what I do, because when I connect and bring opera to unsuspecting people, I see how little they take it for granted. You know, there's a little tendency for us to think, well, this is the way it should be, and da, 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 da. And did we forget about the last 2.5 years? You know, it is a gift from the heavens to make music in whatever capacity, to attend a communal event where people are making music, to experience something that somebody spent years of their life writing, only to bring something beautiful into the world and make us feel something more. I just want to tell this story very quickly, and then we shall say goodnight and come back tomorrow. Maybe I've spoken about this, but part of Carnegie Hall and the Weill Institute of Music that this is a part of, they also go into Sing Sing Prison. And I've been away for 3 years. I don't know how many times I've gone now, but I've been there a number of times. But because of the pandemic, I was away for 3 years, and I went back 2 weeks ago. And a lot of new faces in the program, because a lot of the men had been transferred out or had been released, and so there were a lot of new faces, and they'd only had a few sessions. In case you don't know, Carnegie comes in with Musica Cambia, and they teach men that are incarcerated there to compose music, to learn instruments. There's maybe 20, 25 men in the program, all different ages. And the time just before COVID, Rob decided he wanted to sing opera with me, because sometimes I will sing compositions they've written, sometimes we do duets, but he wanted to do opera, and that was the first time I'd experienced that. And he learned La Ci Darem La Mano, and we performed that in a concert for general population from the prison. This time, three men wanted to sing opera with me, so that's a 300% increase for the impact studies of the popularity of opera. And you know what they learned? Pur ti miro, of Monteverdi. And one of the men saved his money to purchase the track. That's a lot of hours of labor to purchase that track. They studied it, and it was hilarious because they said, so Joyce, they want to do Pur ti miro. I was like, okay. Like, I'm up, I've learned to like be up for anything there. And I was like, oh, okay. And we started Pur ti miro. And the three of them were singing together, and they went, Pur ti godo, like these big operatic voices. And I went, whoa, 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 okay, I get it. I know. It's opera, but it's not that kind of opera. Okay? So I was like, you have to act like there's no start to your sound and there's no finish to your sound, and it has to be pure. It has to be a pure sound. And they went, okay. And I went, Pur ti miro. And I don't know how to describe the change of energy in that place. And there were other men listening, and they all went, ooh, ooh. And that was frickin' Monteverdi. Okay? It was Monteverdi. One of the most pure, I mean, manna from heaven, right? And in that same thing, I brought in what I try to do is bring in what I'm doing on the outside, and I brought a little mini Eden in, and I did a couple things, and then we did Ombra Mai Fu. And I was like, so, you know, because a lot of the men are songwriters, I said, I want you to pay attention. It's kind of a stupid lyric. It's kind of silly. Like, oh, big shade tree, thanks for the shade, you know? And I kind of downplayed it, and I'm so embarrassed. I'm a little ashamed that I did that. But that's my self-deprecating thing of like, well, I know it's opera, but... And then I said, but listen to the melody that he constructs around it, and you'll feel the tree. And I sang it, and it was like meditation in the room. They receive it in a way, I don't know... I wish everybody could experience it. And then in the front row, a guy named Lingo raised his hand, and he goes, I don't mean any disrespect, but I don't think the lyric's that stupid. I'd love to sit under a shade tree right now. And I went, like, thank you. Like, that's a good reminder for me. And it's why I have less and less patience sometimes for our industry, that we underestimate so strongly what we have. And we try to pretend we're something that we're not instead of leaning into it and being more of what we are. for an audience that comes without a classical education, that comes without, you know, they're used to screens, and we can't pretend that they're not where they are. It's 2022. It's a weird time. But we have a key. At the end of the day, one of the guys who sang with me, he came to me with tears in my in his eyes, and I had him in my eyes too, and he said, I just want to thank you for reminding me of my humanity today. And it's that serious, what we do. It's why you guys have so much work to do, because that's what you have the possibility of bringing into the world and sharing with other people. And I don't want to shy away from it. I want to lean into it, because it heals, it transforms, it enlightens, it brings comfort. I mean, I'm all for enlightenment, but let's just use a little comfort right now, too. Let's sit together in a room and go, you felt that, right? I'm not crazy. I'm okay, right? Yeah, you're okay. You're not the first to feel that. And that's the power of what this stuff does. And so, is that education? Is it sharing? Is it, I'm not sure what it is, but I love doing it. And I appreciate when people receive it. It's a very cool thing. And when people take up the baton and carry it on, which we will do tomorrow at 4 o'clock, live on Medici TV and YouTube and here at Carnegie Hall. Thank you guys for coming. We have our fantastic singers in Justina Lee and Ken Noda, our pianists. Thank you guys.